Hi and welcome. Our legal system provides a framework upon which our country develops its laws related to information security. And compliance to these information security laws is the top priority of information security governance and the management. In this video, I will discuss major legal systems and the categories of laws which are developed under these legal systems. Before moving further, please turn on the subtitles for this video. Now, there are three major legal systems, that is the civil legal system, the common legal system, and religious or customary legal system. Now, the civil legal system is most widely used in the world, and the bills are passed by the electives in both houses, that is the lower house and the upper house. For example, in United States, the lower house is the House of Representatives and the upper house is the Senate, and both are part of United States Congress. So these bills are, once passed by the Congress, becomes codified laws. And these laws or statutes should be in conformance with the constitution of that country. For example, in case of United States, these laws should be in conformance with the United States Constitution. So the legislative branch develops these laws, and the judicial branch can review these laws, and it may also invalidate any law. Moreover, the judicial branch then uses these laws for interpretation of different cases. So the executive branch enforces this legal system. So, in civil legal system, the old cases or the judicial precedencies do not carry much weight. Now, in common legal system, it is actually implemented in the part of regions where the English is the main language. For example, the United States, Canada, and United Kingdoms, or the former colonies under United Kingdom. Now, the common legal system uses the codified laws and also the judicial precedencies or the decisions of old cases. So, the judicial precedencies or the interpretations of old cases may carry more weight than the codified laws, and these may supersede the codified laws. So in common legal system, with the passage of time and the changes in the society, the interpretations of the old cases or the judicial precedencies may also change. Now, the third legal system is the religious legal system or the customary legal system. So in religious legal system, the religious interpretations carry much weight, and the Sharia law, which is based upon Quran and Hadith, and it is an Islamic law, this law is most commonly used or most widely used in Islamic countries. Now, Christianity, Judaism, and Hinduism have also their influences over the religious laws. Now, the customary laws are the common practices which are accepted in a group to the extent that they are interpreted as laws. So, they may later be codified as laws by passing a bill by the electives. So in common legal system, there are three types of laws, that is the criminal law, the civil law, and the administrative law. So the objective in criminal law is to protect the society and to keep the society safe. For example, in the United States, the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, or Electronic Communication Privacy Act, or the Identity Fraud and Threat and Assumption Deterrence Act are examples of criminal laws. So the penalties in criminal laws or the violations to the criminal laws are the community services or imprisonment or financial fines or the death penalties in case of grave violations. So in criminal laws, the burden of proof is beyond reasonable doubts. In civil law, it is also known as the tort law. The objective over here is to maintain order in the society and to resolve conflict between people and the firms. So the victim party seek damages due to failed due care by the responsible party. So state over here is only acts as an arbitrator, and it provides the administrative services, for example the court system, to resolve conflict between people. But the state may also act as plaintiff in case if it is a party in the civil matter. So the issue over here is the preponderance of evidences, but these lot of evidences requires much lesser proof as compared to the criminal law, where the burden of proof is beyond reasonable doubt. Now in civil matters, the major penalties are financial. Moreover, these civil laws are also used to provide a framework of governance for executive branch. And executive branch may later on develop the administrative law using this governance framework and budgeting also. So the financial penalties may be statutory, where there has no actual loss occurred to the victim, but since the civil law dictates a fine, so this financial penalty is awarded to the responsible party. And these financial penalty can be compensatory where actual loss has occurred. Or these financial penalties, in addition to these financial penalties, the punitive actions can be awarded to the responsible party, for example, the punishment in case of grave violations to the civil law. Now, in administrative laws, these are the regulations, policies, and procedures which are developed by the executive branch. And in the United States, these laws are covered in Code of Federal Regulation. So administrative laws are used to enforce criminal and civil laws, and these are the government mandated compliance. So the administrative law should also conform to the criminal and civil laws. So these administrative laws are used to perform day-to-day operations of government agencies. And examples of administrative law in the United States are the Federal Communication Commission regulations and Food and Drug Administration regulations and Federal Aviation Administration and Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos. Thank you.